at the feast of Belshazzar and 1,000 of his lords, while they drank from golden vessels, as the Book of Truth records. In the night, as they reveled in the royal palace hall, they were seized with consternation at the hand upon the wall. See the brave captive Daniel as he stood before the throng and rebuked the haughty monarch for his mighty deeds of wrong. As he read out the writing, 'twas the doom of one and all, for the kingdom was now finished, and the hand said the hand upon the wall. See the faith and zeal and courage that would dare to do the right, which the Spirit gave to Daniel, this the secret of his might. In his home in Judea, a captive in its hall, he still understood the writing of his God upon the wall. So our deeds are recorded. There is a hand that's writing now. Sinner, give your heart to Jesus, to his royal mandate bow. For the day is approaching, it must come to one and all, when a sinner's condemnation will be written on the wall.
The truth is right before you. God refuses. No matter what you've been through, he can change it, 'cause he is our God, creator of all. Unless you accept him, you continue to fall. The battle is real, but you, he will call. The devil never wakes, because the writing's on the wall. Just look around and you will see confusion. The God that Stryper serves is not delusion, 'cause he is our God, creator of all. Unless you accept him, you continue to fall. The battle is real, but you, he will call. The devil never wakes, because the writing's on the wall.
The message I have for you tonight is this: sin brings destruction. We started with Ezekiel 18:10. We finished with it. The soul that sinneth, it shall die. Be it a man, a woman, be it a nation. Doom is inevitable in the world as it gets worse and worse. The Bible promises that those who put their faith in Jesus Christ shall escape the wrath to come, shall be delivered from the hour of tribulation, shall be saved from judgment, taken to heaven. What I ask you is to search your own heart and see that you know Christ. Living in this dying, decadent society in America, a country turning its back on the things of God so blatant and flagrant, we are salt and light. We must come to Christ and stand for truth, that others may hear and come to know him as well. God is not willing that any should perish. It's not his desire. He wants us to come to him. It's needful for you in your life, first of all, to come and confess your sin and receive him as Savior, and then for those who know him, to preach the message of judgment and salvation in Christ from that judgment, the good news that Jesus saves and keeps us from the wrath to come. If you don't know Christ, right now in your heart, will you invite Him in? Pray a quiet, silent prayer. Take Christ. If you do know Him, reconfirm that you're willing to stand for His truth in this day. Father, we bless You for our time tonight. Thank You for the wonderful music, the great joy of fellowship. Lord, I can't express the joy in my heart to see the faithfulness of these people to be here. Thrills me, Lord, just thrills me. Thank You for bringing them and for their wonderful faithfulness and for them wanting to open their lives to the conviction of the Word of God. Bless them for it, Lord. And for one or so who are here tonight and they don't know Jesus Christ, may this be the night they come for forgiveness, for salvation. For those of us who do, Lord, give us a new zeal to preach His truth, to stand against the decay of our time, boldly and courageously take our stand. For Christ's sake, amen. I trust that you'll share this message with others. I believe it's important that our people in our country see that we are paralleling the same track that caused the fall of Babylon. People, it's a great, great, great task, isn't there, ahead of us, to reach men and women. God doesn't want the perishing, and neither do we. We don't sit back and say, oh, it's inevitable. We go into the highways and byways and compel them to come in. Hope you'll do that.